President Marcos defends his veto of a bill granting tax exemptions to allowances and other benefits given to election workers. Marcos says granting more tax exemptions will go against the government's thrust to simplify tax payments. He adds election workers will be given financial aid instead.
We are trying to simplify yung payment ng BIR. Ngayon, kung lalagyan natin ang bagong kategorya yan, and there will be a more chance of leakage, na confusion, mas mahirap gawin, mas magkakaproblema baka yung iba, the red tape, makakain lang ng red tape yan. So that's one reason why we did not do it.
The Alliance of Concerned Teachers earlier slammed the president's veto, calling it a slap in the face of every teacher who served in the past elections.
Masakit sa amin na yung batayan ay kailangan daw paitingin yung collection ng buwis. Nabanggit na kanina, marami namang hindi nagbabayad ng buwis. Kasi una-una, ang rason po na mayor na kung bakit natin ito isinulong ay hindi po kasi trabaho ng mga teachers yung pagservisyo sa election, no? Ito ay extra services na nire-render ng ating mga teachers, ekstrang sakripisyo, no, na dinadagdag natin sa balikat ng ating mga teachers. Yung pong transportation allowance, no, sa totoo lang kulang po 'yon, no, na ginagamit ng mga teachers natin sa pagtransport ng ballot boxes, ng election paraphernalia. Nag-aabono po sila dito, ay pinatungan mo pa ng tax.
The House of Representatives approves a resolution backing the medium-term fiscal framework of the Marcos administration. The vote came after a grueling interpellation of its principal sponsor, Malikina Representative Stella Kimbo, by Albay Representative Edsel Lagman. Lagman called the framework mere planning targets by the government. But Kimbo argued the resolution is important since it indicates the policy direction of the Marcos administration in the next 6 years. The resolution would express the House and eventually the Senate's support for the economic targets of the government from 2022 to 2028 and the proposed strategies of the economic managers. It would also recognize the importance of a fiscal consolidation and resource mobilization plan to include measures such as right-sizing of government structures and personnel and encouraging localized investments and growth programs.